I'm quite sure Chinese government will adopt a more expansionary fiscal and monetary policy. I think the key is still how to increase investment in infrastructure, because China's consumption growth will not be very strong because a lot of uncertainties. And also, China's export will be running into some difficulties. So the only thing is under the control of the Chinese government is infrastructure investment. I think this is a very important weapon for Chinese government to fight against the economic slowing down, so on and so forth. I think now more and more Chinese towns are arguing that the Chinese government should pay less attention to so-called 3% budget deficit or GDP ratio. This is not sort of a, we should break this taboo. And China should raise its budget deficit or GDP ratio, maybe to 5% or even higher. And because China has quite large, quite ample room for use more expansionary fiscal policy, this time around should have some difference from the 4 trillion packages in 2008. The main difference should be that Chinese government, central government should foot the bill to use more government expenditure rather than ask local governments to borrow from commercial banks. And so I think in the future, China's government bonds market will develop very quickly. I think this is something very important. China is in a position to maintain a high growth rate. I'm quite sure China will be able to overcome the temporary difficulties to maintain a sustainable, decent growth rate in the future.